Paul Raymond. And once again, Northern Transvaal are really going to have their work cut out to chase what is a sizable target. Paul Raymond really got going, and that has boosted the overall rate to almost 5 and over, which is quite a tall order for Northern Transvaal to make over 45 overs. So great excitement at St. George's Park, with those last 5 overs or so providing superb entertainment for a big crowd on a glorious late afternoon come early evening. And really it was the most amazing innings from Paul Raymond. Jacqueline, have you seen an onslaught of that like that of late?
It happens from time to time, Trevor. When a tail-ender comes in with very little to lose. But as I was saying during the commentary, I just didn't understand the bowling tactics. I know the norm is to bowl it full at the off stump at batsman at the end of the innings, but when that doesn't work, you've got to try something else. And the Northern Transvaal bowler stuck to that. I mean, the very last ball of the innings was bowled outside the off stump and full, and there was no third man in place. So there was I think the bowlers must have a good look at themselves here and say, okay guys, we didn't get it together, we're not always going to get it right, and we all understand that. But by and large, tactically, I thought that the last 5 overs wasn't very well handled.
And as a result, Eastern Province, being 160 for 8 going into those last 5 overs, have boosted it to 221 for 8. And that is a sizable score in B&H Night Series cricket. And Eastern Province supporters will go to supper rather pleased. We'll be back when play resumes at about 25 to 8.
So for the latest score on the match, we cross over to Trevor Quirk at St. George's Park.
Well, John, here, Northern Transvaal are 38 for 1, and we're into the 12th over of their innings. And the men at the wicket, Mike Haseman, 17, and Louis Foster on 14. And let's reflect for a moment on that incredible innings of Eastern Province, who were asked to bat by Mandy Yachert. Vessels and Rushmere put on a splendid 95 for the second wicket. Fenter a useful 18. Richardson 10 from 15 balls. But the real fireworks was left for the last 5 overs, when after being 98 for 1, Eastern Province lost 7 wickets for 62 runs, with Paul Raymond coming in last then, smashing 43 not out of 20 balls with 1-6 and 8-4s, and putting on 61 for the last wicket with Kepler Vessels. So a sizable 222 needed by Northern Transvaal. They are 38 for 1 in the 12th over. As he's taken 42 wickets at an average of only 19 and a strike rate of 29. It's all pretty good, and he's kept it down to under 4 runs to the over, the last statistic in that column. Not so bad. Starts with a wide down the leg side. And if he puts in a good bowling performance this evening, I'm sure he might win the man of the match after that 43 not out in 20 balls with 8-4s and a 6. And that's going to be 4 runs. Fred Schultz, the man who failed to stop that. Haseman on 39.
Can't help but think, Trevor, that Brett Schultz is a bit too wide at mid-on. He's got a man behind him and to his right, deep straight, sort of straight deep mid-wicket position. So if the ball gets to the left of Schultz at mid-on with Haseman facing, then it's going to go for four as it did. However, if it beats him to the right, it can't go for more than two. So the feeling is that he should be a little bit straighter at mid-on anyway. But now we have a left-hander facing, so it isn't quite the same, although the field is similar.
Adjudicator tonight, a good old friend of all of ours, played against him in his day for Eastern Province, Simon Besaidenhout. So originally from Northern Transvaal. Foster, who has tremendous timing. So he keeps the bowling. He's 240 to Haseman, 79 for two, and 22 overs are now gone. And so it's time to hand over to our
Lee Barnard aanteken. Sy dryf na 'n bal, kry die rand van die kolf by, klop vir Shaw.
Daar is 'n paar keer dat ons dit al vanavond gesien het, dat Kolwer vooral in die begin van die beurt so gelukkige 4 of 2 van die rand van die kolf kry. Venter het dit gedoen in die beurt van die oostelike provinsie. 3 gelukkige 4 gekry voor die ouders van 18. Louis Foster het begin met so'n skramsoukie vir 4. Nou die Barnard ook. Hier is ook 'n man wat die vermoë het om het Raymond. Hier kom hy in een enkele beurt en hy verdubbel amper daar die 26 met sy 43. Hy sy voete.
Raymond wat bal van die verkeerde voet af. Normaalweg trap die bowlers hulle voorvoet vas en dan laat hulle die bal los bo in die hand uit. Hy wat van sy regtervoet af die bal aflewer.
Hy is natuurlijk die naaste by so van die verkeerde voet en so aksie soos Praik van Natal nie. Wat kykers die afgelope 2 wedstryde verstom het met sy bal aksie. Sondag nog het hy 3 baie goeie paltjies gekry. Al 3 slag op verskoon gebouw toe hy teen Noord-Transvaal gespeel het. En hier is het Haseman wat heeltemal geklop is door die bal. Hy kyk na die een kant, die bal trek na die ander kant, maar hy kry het ook. Hier is die bal actie van Raymond.
Hou gerust op. Bal van die verkeerde voet af. Beweeg mooi in. Verskil tussen hom en Praik. Hy kom sy aansig na die paalpies toe en dan bal hy. Mike Proctor vroeger jare het ook een soortgelijke balstijl gehad. Goeie aflevering wat vir Lee Barnard klop. Bal wegswaaier vir hom. Bal wat oor sy lijf beweeg het, deur na die paalpie lag. kon miskien daai voorvoet net 'n bietjie verder gestrek het, dan sou die bal bygekom het.
Op die punteleer is Noord-Transvaal en die Oostelike provinsie in 'n taamlike stryd gewikkel om nog in die prentjie te bly. Interessant die kamera skoot. Lekker gedierte daar sit. Noord-Transvaal het 4 wedstryde gespeel waarvan hulle nog net 1 gewin het en die Oostelike provinsie 3 gespeel waarvan hulle net 1 gewin het. Dus die span wat vanaand hier verloor is amper onmoontlik vir daardie span om nog die halfeindronde te bereik. Span in de competitie. Met andere woorden, hulle speel 7 wedstrijde.
Daarvoor. Is een volbal wat hy ontvang. Slaan die bal dan hard. Vind die gaping by puntveldwerker afgrens toe.
Hofman is een man wat vandag baie goed veldwerk gedoen het van Noord-Transvaal. Moet sê dat die Noord-Transvaalse grondveldwerk vandag werklik goed was. Van die beste wat ek al hierdie seisoen gesien het. En vooral Hofman dan in die buitenveld suiwer veldwerk gedoen en ook goed ingegooi na die bal te wagte. Hy gaan middenbaan grens toe. Buitenveld is baie vinnig. Hy word goed gekeer deur Flam Michel.
Baie goeie spanwerk deur die twee OP veldwerkers. Michou wat duik om keer voor die tou, dan gaan die bal tou toe. Ons kan net nie sien die ander veldwerker duik in en keer om weg van die tou af. Baie goeie spanwerk.
Ja, amper het die toeskouer daar die bal geraak en dan was dit 4. Weer dieselfde situasie, behalwe dat die bal nie heeltemal so hard geslaan is nie. Michou kan hierdie keer die keerwerk doen en die applaus is vir die 100-tal van Noord-Transvaal op die telbord. Goeie tempo waard in hulle kolf, 4 lopies om en by per bilbeurt.
Raymond wat op die stadium beide kante van die paaltjies bol en dit is nie wat Kepler Wessels van hom wil heen nie.
Dis een veel beter bal. Uitloper.
Het is altijd baie moeilik vir bowlers met die bowlstyl om een bal weg van die rechterhandse cover te beweeg en elke slag as hulle dit probeer dan is hulle geneig om weg te val en in die proces verloor hulle richting.
8 uitlopers is dit is ver afgestuur door die OP bowlers. rug langs, maar hy gaan Duskan Baptiste grondvat en is een aan Huisman.
Mike Huisman wat gelukkig is, sy daai bal in die vleis van die kolf gekry, dan sou hy beslis uitgevang gewees het. Gelukkig vir hom tref hy die bal hoog op die kolf en het die bal nie ver genoeg gedra vir Baptiste om die vangskoot waar te neem nie.
Beter bal, amper streepbal. Het weer amper een kwestie omdat die Kolwers probleme van homself skep.
En die keer sou dit Hofman se skuld gewees het. Hy roep vir die lopie, skrik dan as hy sien Schulz op die bal afstorm. Dan skree hy nie, maar Huisman is al reeds op pad. En gelukkig vir hom is hy vinnig genoeg tussen die palkies. En kom hy betyds in sy kolkamp.
Dis nabij. Baie vinnige hardloop deur Baptiste, skitterend opgetel. Kry applaus van die skare, goeie cricket. Atleties hierdie West-Indiërs, alle wêreld. Vol spoed hardloop hy. Steek daar die lang regterarm uit. Pik hom op en slinger hom in.
Dit was werklik goeie cricket geweest. Dit was net so goeie hou geweest. Die bal was aan die wegkant geplaas. Maar Huisman met die gaap om die bykant gaan soek. Voer 'n dryfhouer uit. Dan goeie veldwerk.
Loserige bal wat vierloopies werd is. Huisman het om suiver op verdienste gespeel. Gesien hier kom een wat net op die perfecte lijn geplant is vir die dekpunt drie. Bryson die veldwerker.
Ook Steve Elworthy wat sy rekening open met die bal wat van die rand van die kolf afkom, waar glippe sou gewees het deur skiet na die derde man grens.
Door die binnenring veldwerkers, maar as een man wat van middenbaan af van die grens af kan inkom, Rashmir, wat die veldwerk doen.
Kepler Wessels uitgeslapen kaptein, en is baie moeilik vir die twee kolvers om die gapings te vind. Speel hom, maar waar hom ook al speel is daar veldwerker wat hom tot een minimum van 1 beperk.
Losbal afgestuur deur Raymond, die bal wat te vroeg geswaai het. Bryson kan die veld wel doen.
Vleed na Tim Shaw, net 3 van die puntpositie, miskien een weierige gangiekie. En ons is nie heeltemal seker of die bal lig langs tot by hom getrek het nie.
Nee, ja. Dis kant om grond gevat, goed gekeer. En as laatste noem ons ware vernootskap toerisverf was om die tweede paankie tussen Foster en Huisman wat die telling geneem het van 8 voor 1 na 70 voor 2. 90 lopies om te win. Nou daar die tempo aangegroei na amper 7 per bilbeurt met net 4 paankie staande. Goeie bal van Raymond, klop voor Jennings.
Soortgelijke hou wat hy uitvoer van een soortgelijke bal. Speel bietjie te laat daarna miskien. Op geklop in dieselfde wat een man soos Raymond die kolf verlaat. En daai het beslis op die laaste oomblik net die kolf so even verlaat.
Ja, daar die bal aksie van hom is het baie moeilik om die wegswaaier te bal. Bring ons saak ook terug na die kolf toe. Skote kan jy sien die mistigheid wat nog hier is, die rokerigheid. Maar die heel wat vuurtjies wat hier vanavond aangesteek is, gasbraaiers.
Raymond wat die stariger aflevering afstuur by Jennings wat hom mooi sien en dan bal net omdraai na die recht by posisie toe waar Philip M. die veld heeft. Philip M. wat spook om sy plek op te speel in die span na Australië, ongelukkig vanavond uitgehardloop met sy telling op 2.
Einde van die bilbeurt, met die grote taal op 135 vir die verlies van 6. Hierna gesels Trevor Cooke en Robin Jackman verder.
Feel there from Raymond, but it was only him that really went up because I think we could hear it from here. A little bit of bat on that.
Batsman this evening to drag the ball back onto his stumps. The ball not bouncing quite as high as he would have liked. Elworthy going the same way as Michal, who dragged the ball on from Lee Barnard. And of Ian Hoffman, who was dismissed not long ago. A dreadful way to get out. Only one worse, I think, and that's run out. Caught down the leg side. Yeah, just the inside edge, the left elbow tucked down low, so the bat not coming through, absolutely horizontal to the ground. But when you're needing 8 and over, one can't be a perfectionist.
Willie Morris, the new batsman, the tall left-arm spinner, bowled very well today, 3 for 34 from his 9 overs. Put Northern Transvaal right back in business at 160 for 8. And then we had that onslaught from Wessels and from Raymond. Over from Paul Raymond. A maiden wicket bowled by him, two maidens in a row that we've had now. You see that with 10 overs to go, not much in it between the two sides in terms of runs scored after 35 overs. Eastern Province in the much healthier position of having 3 wickets in hand. It did collapse to 160 for 8 though before that 61 run partnership in 5 overs at the end. More than well up to him those deliveries, but able to take advantage of it. There's a nice big gap through extra cover. And then on the boundary at long off and at cover point. He does find that gap now, but hasn't quite got the timing. And Fent is very quick in the field. Throwing has been an absolute delight this evening, rifling things right over the top of the stumps from the boundary. Certainly having lots of fun this evening. So you see that with 8 overs to go, Northern Transvaal actually have a 4-run edge on Eastern Province at the same stage, but they have lost those 2 extra wickets. But a few more mighty blows like total. 152 for 8 now. This is the 39th over. Jennings moves to double figures. This is up in the air and he could be caught and is. As he didn't even bother to run. Didn't even bother to cross over. Maybe it is the end of the over, so Jennings needed to stay put. But he hardly had to move. Did Van Michaal on the back.
The ball's up there for a very long time. Michaal absolutely stationary.
Bomb. Was saying that you haven't seen him score too many runs.
Yeah, this season I haven't. It's the third naught that I've seen him record. But a pretty hopeless situation for him.
So a string of unfortunate results for Northern Transvaal in limited over cricket. As Tertius Bosch comes out to bat. He's no great shakes with the willow.
You must know, Trevor, what a hopeless feeling it is to walk out at number 11 and score 10 and over. You must wonder whether you can't just wave a white flag from the balcony. But there have been occasions when the extraordinary has happened. But I've got to have my doubts tonight.
I've got to stake my life on it. That was interesting. Must have hit in the foot marks, I would imagine, for it to take off like that down the leg side. A wide call.
Very wide and very full.
Nicely played by Jennings, down to mid-wicket, but there's a man on the fence, just the single. Looking shot from a number 11.
It's the best shot I've ever seen Tertius Bosch play.
So the end of Paul Raymond's spell. 9 overs, 2 for 45. And to go with that absolutely devastating 43 not out with 8 fours and a 6 from 20 balls. A partnership of 61 with Kepler Wessels in the last 5 overs at over 12 runs to the over. Quite amazing game he's had, and he must be a candidate for man of the match to be decided this evening by former Eastern Province and Northern Transvaal opening batsman Simon Besaidenhout. Schultz, who's continuing from the Duck Pond end, must Haseman and Foster Foster looked in good nick until he was cordon bowled by Shaw, just not going through with his shot. Haseman blossomed to top score of 59, played some lovely shots, and then was caught on the mid-wicket boundary by Fenter off a short delivery from Schultz. There hasn't been a lot more on offer. Now it's Bryson to Jennings, who just taps it. Pursuit of the 222 required for victory. Vessels and Rushmere putting on a fine 95 for the second wicket, and then Vessels and Raymond 61 for the ninth wicket. Useful B&H total. Four. Eastern Province don't mind that. Bosch will be quite chuffed with what he has ended up with on the scoreboard. But Eastern Province have won comfortably in the end. And Robin Jackman, I must put you on the spot and say, who, if you were the adjudicator, would you make man of the match?
You have put me on the spot, because it's really not an easy decision. I think Schultz, 4 for 32, is a performance that has to take... be taken into a great deal of consideration. It's all very well to score a big total, but you've got to knock the opposition over quickly. So he'd be one. Raymond obviously gave EP a decent target, having looked in all sorts of trouble with his brilliant innings. And Vessels held it all together and marshalled his troops very well in the field. Being a bowler, I think I'd go for Schultz.
Well, gone. Paul Raymond has just been made the man of the match for his 43 of 20 balls, and the fact, of course, that he did pick up two wickets, although they were a little bit on the expensive side. 45 runs conceded from his nine overs. But yes, it's all very well saying that the score is there, made possible by Raymond's onslaught. But to prevent Northern Transvaal from getting anywhere near, somebody's got to bowl well, and young Brett Schultz certainly did that. 4 for 32 from his nine overs. Bryson was tidy enough, but then the slog wasn't on here at the end. And Tim Shaw did a good job too. 2 for 33 from his nine with a left-arm spin. And likewise, Baptiste at the end here got away with the batsman not having a go, although he did bowl two maidens and bowled a pretty tidy line. Paul Raymond, the most expensive of the bowlers, but picking up two wickets to go with that splendid innings of his. So that's what we had for you from St. George's Park. Northern Transvaal all out for 184 in the end. And not all out, 184 for 9 indeed. In fact, there might have been 188 for 9, because the scoreboard, I don't think, has credited Bosch with his last four runs. So Bosch had 19 to end with, 21 to Jennings, 184 for 9, 188 for 9 rather, and victory by 33
runs. Eastern Province made 215 for 5 in their allotted 55 overs. Mike Langer reports.
Eastern Province got off to a bad start,